Hello, my name is Robert Dean Steele, and this is your daily Bible class. We're looking at Revelation chapter 21. Listen to what it says here. We're reading from the New International Version, a new heaven and new earth. I saw a new heaven and new earth. Now, the first heaven and earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. So, what had happened, of course, is we have the great white throne judgment, and the old heaven and the old earth have passed away. And then we begin to see a creation of a brand new heaven and earth. And at the time, there wasn't any sea any longer. So we're looking at a whole brand new planet. And from what we can see here, there is no need for any longer any ocean upon this new planet. And then he says, I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem coming down out of heaven. So here you have this new heaven, this new earth, and God is about to plant a brand new city in the midst of that new heaven and new earth. And it says it was prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. So this new heaven, this new earth has been created. The city is coming down, and it's a beautiful brand new city, literally like a bride dressed for her husband. And it says, I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, look, God's dwelling place is now among the people. So here you have this beautiful city coming down and a voice saying, this is the new dwelling place for God's people, and he will dwell with them in that new place. So it's not just, you know, metaphorically speaking. This is an actual literal dwelling of the Lord with his people. We've been looking forward to this day. We've seen the destruction of this old heaven and this old earth. And now it's a brand new time period. It's a brand new day. It's a brand new period. And we're looking at it and it says, they will be his people and God himself will be with them and will be their God. So you have this wonderful, literally, dwelling together of the Lord with his people. And the marvelous thing is, we are his people. You see, the wicked has been judged. And so now, this is paradise restored, you might say. Garden of Eden, but even in a greater measure. Interesting is that man was planted in a beautiful garden, and we've been trying to get back to Eden ever since. We've been trying to recapture paradise, not realizing that there is something greater coming even than Eden. It is the new Jerusalem, and God himself will be there. And it says he will wipe every tear from their eye, and there will be no death, no mourning, no crying, no pain, for the order of old things have passed away. You see, sin brought all kinds of things. It brought mourning, it brought death, and crying, and pain. And all of those things have now been eradicated. They have been erased. It is a brand new day. The Lord himself has erased all these things. He has taken care of them. When Jesus Christ died on the cross, he allowed mankind to have a little spark of that abundant life, you might say. But we will now see the full fruition of this in Revelation chapter 21. All the old things have passed away. Behold, all things are becoming new. Now, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5:17 that the old has passed away, and behold, all things are becoming new. But this is now the time period where everything is new. And it says in verse number 5, he who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. Then he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. He says, John, you are now seeing what is about to come. We have our time period of grace. We have the tribulation period. We have 1,000 years of reigning on Christ on the earth, on the old earth, and this present earth, and this present heavens. But then we have the great white throne judgment, and then now we have the presentation of the new heaven and new earth. And all of this is in our immediate future. You say, my immediate future? Well, you have to understand something. With God, 1,000 years is like a day, and a day is like 1,000 years. Time and space and matter and motion mean nothing to God. And it won't mean anything to us. But he says this. He says, I am making everything new. This is the time, Revelation chapter 21, everything is going to be. He says, write these down, for these are the trustworthy said. He said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost and with from the spring of the water of life. He says, listen, I want you to know something. And I love that statement. It is done. It's like when Jesus was hanging on the cross and he said, it is finished. This time period where Satan is ruling on the earth. Literally, when he was hanging on the cross, that's what he did. He destroyed the works of the devil on the cross. And the resurrection stamped it and said, it is done. But here in this Revelation chapter 21, the new heaven has been created. The new earth has been created. The new Jerusalem is coming down. And the Lord has said, you need to know this, John. He says, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the beginning and the end. I started things. I will end things. Everything starts with me. Everything ends with me. The reason why you even have breath is because I created you out of the dust of the earth and I breathed into your nostril and you became a living soul. But know this now, John. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life, which he will be talking about in a little time period just before. And he says this, those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. He says, all who are victorious, all who have overcome, all who have looked beyond this present age. You see, folks, we're constantly being tempted with staying in this world. You know, there are some people say, this is the best it gets, not realizing it's not the best it is. Maybe they've had everything in life, like the rich man, and there are some who are like Lazarus and had nothing. But you see, this is not the best it is. We're still passing through. We're pilgrims passing through. He says, when you understand that, and when you've been victorious, when you've gone to the other side, he says, you will inherit all of this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. What a glorious day to have when we will see the Lord face to face and have the promise that we will be his children. What a wonderful thought. Then he closes off by saying, but the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those who practice magic arts, and the idolaters, and all liars, they will be consigned to the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death. You see, if someone dies without knowing Jesus Christ, they go to hell. But then they are held there until the day of judgment, the great white throne judgment. And he says, listen, he says, and he lists, you know, some of the things he says, the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murder, the sexually immoral, those who practice magic art, the idolaters, and all liars. You notice it says at the end, all liars, because most of us have no problem stretching the truth, bending the truth, busting the truth, saying, well, it's just a little white lie. But you see, what God is making very clear is that there is no distinction when it comes to sin. Sin is sin. You might be a murderer. You might be a gossip. You might be a thief. You might be a liar. But any way you have, if you continue on in that praxis and you do not confess that sin and renounce that sin and receive God's forgiveness, you are going to face, as it says here, they will be consigned to the fiery lake of burning sulfur. You see, he says, those who have followed their own ways. They followed the beast. They followed the Antichrist. They followed the false prophet. They followed Satan. Satan has been their king and their god. He says they have all been consigned already to the fiery lake of fire. He says this is the second death. They will never come out of that place. They will never enjoy what you and I are going to enjoy when we give our lives to Jesus Christ. And he says, you need to know that this is trustworthy and true. All of this is in the near future. So my encouragement is, give your life to Jesus Christ and get ready for what's coming, because it's going to be absolutely fabulous. My name is Robert Dean Steele. This is your daily Bible class. You have yourself a great and godly day.